Good evening and welcome to Soquel High School. I'm Rusty Reed along with Pat Lovell bringing you tonight's Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League Wrestling Championship. It's all down to tonight. They've been going at it all year long. The blood, sweat, and tears comes down to 14 league champions tonight. Pat Lovell, former Olympian in wrestling, he'll be bringing us our analysis tonight. And they've been going at it all day. We've seen a lot. What is the status of wrestling here in the Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League, Pat?
Well, we have a very strong showing again from Aptos High School, the defending champion. And we've had some things happen in the league, you know, some real close dual meet matches where injuries to wrestlers have come into play. And that has hurt a couple of the teams in trying to challenge Aptos at this time. We've had a great Santa Cruz High School. Their program has really come on this year. Last year they were down to like four wrestlers. They have a new coach who's Emilio Ariano, and they have about 25 wrestlers out, which is very, very good turnout for the Santa Cruz program, which used to be a powerhouse. So I think you're going to see some changes. Some of the other teams are going to get better as the year goes on, and that's the stage
right now. Aptos, they're 7 championships in 8 years, and SLB will give them a run for their money for the team title. They're lining up on the mat. We have 7 teams from the Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League. St. Francis High School, the first year with a wrestling team out of that program.
Yeah, that was great to have them come on board, where they gave us 7 teams in the league now.
All right.
Greg Lopez.
Yes, we're going to sign off and be right back with the first weight, 115 pounds, right after this.
Thank you.
Okay, Rusty, looks like we're ready to go here. 106-pound weight class. Chris Markey from San Lorenzo Valley against, who's coached by Ken Palestrini and Todd Kerr. He's currently 25-8 and ranked number 14th in the SCCAL. CCS.
And he'll be going against Russell Combs, a freshman. So two freshmen at 106 pounds. That Markey, he's 14th in CCS as a freshman. He's made quite a mark. He's got a great record. Comes in with a record of 25-8. Markey from San Lorenzo Valley High School and Russell Combs from Santa Cruz High School, both undefeated in league.
Yeah, Rusty, I might say that Chris Markey, I know his dad from the junior college days when I was coaching at Cabrillo. His dad was a very outstanding wrestler at Chabot College, went on to Cal State Bakersfield where he competed. So you know it's in the genes. Markey is a tough little guy. He's only 106 pounds, but he's very tough.
So they've been wrestling all afternoon, junior varsity, and then quarters and semifinals to leading up to the finals here tonight. There'll be 14 matches, 14 weight classes from 108 pounds to the heavyweights.
Yeah, and I see the coaches and some of the wrestlers out there now are wiping off the mat. They just re-cleaned the mat again before the finals. So there's still some wet spots. So it reminds me of the Warriors game when those guys fall down and the people come running from the side with the towels to wipe the floor up. So these guys could probably go to work for the Warriors the next time around.
So we'll have high school wrestling, like college, three two-minute periods?
Yes, it'll be three two-minute periods. At the end of the first period, the referee will flip the disc. Whatever color comes up, red or green, will have his choice to take top, bottom, or defer. And from that point on, it just changes in the third period. Takedowns with control in with one wrestler, supporting points inbound is 2 points. The reversal is 2 points. Escapes are 1 point. Near falls are, they could be 2, 3, or 4. Or even 5 with a penalty situation.
So here we go. It's Combs in the Santa Cruz, red and white, and San Lorenzo Valley, Chris Markey in the black, red, and white. For the league championship, 106 pounds. Markey's got to be the favorite from SLV. Highly ranked in CCS as well.
Yeah, it's a good job. They're both a nice double leg shot there by Markey for 2 point takedown. It's amazing, Rusty, you see some of the skill level of some of these ninth graders, these freshmen in high school. They have very good skills. You see Markey working for the cradle, near side cradle. He's got the cradle. He's now scoring near fall points. Holds him there for 5 seconds. He's got to get 3 points. Still working for the pin. It's tough to get a guy down. The cradle's a great move to score points on, but a lot of times it's hard to get that inside shoulder down because it's up against your chest as you're trying to pin him. Same maneuver. He won't get another 3 points because he has not changed the hold. Now if he goes back to the cradle, he would get another 3 points.
So Combs waited him out there, avoiding the pin.
Yes, Yeah, he's doing a good job defensively. Markey's got him again. He works on that cradle. I think we got a new 2 point near fall because he held him for 2 seconds that time.
So yeah, defensively, Combs, a nice job. I mean, avoiding the pin twice. He's got his hands full with Markey for sure.
Yeah, got to make sure he can't get that one knee up near his head, or he's in big trouble for that cradle. Looks like Markey, that might be his trademark move. Markey trying to switch, comes into a stand up.
See the clock, Pat.
The clock must be on the table. Yeah, they're not.
2 minute periods.
Yeah, they're not using the thing. Here we are in the second period. We have no idea what time. You kind of still feel it. There goes Markey with a duck under. Duck under for another 2 point takedown. Now he's working that bar half, cranking the half Nelson, driving it hard.
A lot of points for Markey. He's up over Combs, 10-0 here in the second of three periods.
And there's your fall.
So Chris Markey, the freshman from San Lorenzo Valley High School, league champion at 106 pounds. On to CCS.
Next stop, CCS. You're right. That's a big one for them. Especially when you're a freshman.
So next weight class, 115 pounds. It'll be Gabby Sandoval, league champion, defending league champion, against George Mendoza. Mendoza out of Soquel High School and Gabby Sandoval from Scotts Valley.
Kind of a sad story about Gabby. You know, Gabby was a number one ranked girl wrestler in CCS, came down sick and was not able to wrestle in the CCS tournament to get a chance to win the state championship. So she's here tonight, you know, wrestling for her team, for team points and so forth. And it's a real shame that she did not get a chance to go to state. It was a nice takedown she had. I think it was a double leg that she took her down with. She's working, trying to control the wrist to get some type of a tilt. Working good on the breakdown. She's riding very well. She's got her arm bar, trying to work the arm bar.
Gabby's a junior, Mendoza a sophomore. Mendoza in the blue of Soquel. Gabby, number one ranked CCS in girls and unable to compete in that meet.
I remember
when she won league last year. That was, I think, the first league girls league champ, or first league champion that was a girl.
Yes, correct? I think so, yeah. I think Domino Parrish would have been, but what she did is when she wrestled in the league finals, is she, Domino, was one of the outstanding wrestlers from Scotts Valley High School, who's now up at Simon Fraser University up in Canada. And she has just got second place in the Nationals. And she would have probably, or could have won our league championship, but she defaulted in the finals, did not wrestle for first place. Gabby's working on top. You know, Gabby was first at the Ed Farrell Classic, second at the Weber Lawson Classic, third at the Nick Buzlich Tournament, second at the Baylor's Bash, and second at the 50th Peninsula Invitational. Right now, you see it on her bio here, she's working to get her health back to 100%. I noticed she was, I saw her earlier today, she's using I don't know if she's using an inhaler or not, but she had bronchitis, and you know, that just takes the wind out of your sails. Have an injury timeout now. I think Mendoza must have a bloody nose, I think is what our holdup is.
Scotts Valley coach, Freddie Cortez, chatting it up with Gabby there.
You know, at this time too, I'd like to introduce the referees we have working tonight, finals. Abram Ross is out on the mat. He's the referee on the mat. His assistant is Gene Nanez, and our other official is Nate Urbancic, former Soquel wrestler. Gene Nanez's brother wrestled for me way back in the 70s, late 60s and early 70s, when I was head coach at James Lick High School. His brother was a Northern California champion, was 43-0 his senior year. Get all the blood wiped up and they'll be ready to go.
George Mendoza at the bottom here as they go. Coached by Torres, Shane Torres. Right away, Gabby on the offensive.
Yeah, Gabby's a tough rider. You can tell she's had a lot of experience. She knows where her hips are supposed to be and how to keep that upper body down to the mat so you can't get anything going for you.
Two nothing, so close match here so far. That first match with Markey was 10-0 before that fall or pin. Oh, there we go.
Nice reversal there by Gabby on a switch move, which we call a switch, which she changes that position from bottom to top. It's a two-point maneuver that she just put together there. Nice job on that. You notice she's tall, too, for a girl in her weight class. She's very tall, so she has good leverage. You find a wrestler who's like that, who has strength and has a long, elongated body, they have a lot of leverage. Here she's working on that wrist ride, inside wrist ride. She's trying to work it up into an arm bar, but Mendoza is giving her a good fight. There's one penalty point for Gabrielle, stalling call on Mendoza.
Camila Baracco.
There she goes.
Also at this weight class.
Yeah, she almost had him with that half Nelson. She had him going in the turn, but she couldn't quite get to the side. There's still working that arm bar.
Alec Neuberger's in the 113 class, along with Maya Lantona, Aiden Largue, all mostly freshmen. A lot of people thought Camila Baracco would be in this final against Gabby. And George Mendoza pulls it off.
Yeah.
So, Kel, I noted not a lot of wrestlers at the lighter weights, but boy, when you get to the heavyweights, it's a lot of Soquel High School.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of the smaller weight classes. I noticed that in watching them in their dual meets. You notice Gabby has her inhaler now. Mendoza's bleeding, and Gabby's using her inhaler. Gabby is really looking placed in the top three at the Folk Style Nationals in Oklahoma next month. And she'd like to thank her coaches and thank her dad for always supporting her 100%. And thanks her mom for always feeding her.
And again, only a junior, so looking to become back-to-back champion.
Yeah.
Here in league. And maybe as a senior, make it three in a row if she can get past Mendoza here. She's up on points, 5-0. Third period. Mendoza really needs a fall here.
Nice single leg move there. Caught Mendoza coming forward. Took that single leg. She's back in the control position again. Now, the thing about the girls wrestling, Rusty, is they have their own section championship, and which Gabby was not able to wrestle in because of an illness. And they also have their own state tournament, which is, I think, coming up shortly, or it might have been this weekend. I'm not sure.
So boys CCS is yet to come, where girls CCS wrestling happened last weekend. Late in the third period, Sandoval up 7-0 on points.
Yeah, she's been in total control the whole match. Poor Mendoza hasn't been able to get any kind of an offense going at all.
Well, you're going against the defending league champ. Now you're going to have your hands full.
Yeah, Mendoza's still leaking a little bit up top, so take another timeout. They get five minutes timeout for bleeding. Some of the kids, you know, are just that way. They get hit in the face and they bleed easy, and takes a while to get it stopped.
And some housekeeping on the mat as well. We're at SoCal High School hosting the 2017
and we'd like to
version
thank,
of the league title.
Yeah, we'd like to thank Stu Walters for hosting the league championship tonight. He's done an outstanding job. They call him the king of the kettle corn.
Last year's league championships that you and I brought to community television of Santa Cruz County was up at Scotts Valley High School. Louie Walters hosting that, the athletic director up there. So here we go.
It's Gabby on top again. Traps that arm again, working to do that head crush on him, try and get it to turn. Working for that arm bar. You see her got the 2-on-1 on that arm, trying to lift it up.
Gabby,
put the pressure in his back with the elbow. There she goes. She's got him starting to turn.
And time about to run out on Mendoza. And there you have it. Gabriella Sandoval, second year in a row, league champion. So that's a league first.
Yeah.
Never had a gal be a league champ 2 years in a row. A nice big hug, George Mendoza.
Yeah. Yeah, her coach, Freddie Cortez, a great guy. Former James Lick High School wrestler. Wrestled for Ray Jimenez over there. She's a happy camper now.
Ah, hugs all around. The junior, second time league champ. Go for the hat trick next year.
Yep.
And now we move on to 120 pounds. It'll be Jeremiah Aguirre, the senior, SLV in the red and black, against Joe Hamana out from Scotts Valley, only a sophomore.
Aguirre is coached by Ken Palestrini and Todd Kraft. He's got a record of 24-7, just scored a takedown for 2 points. And he's ranked number 8 in the CCS. He's a hard worker. You know, he had a good season last year, and he's really come on this year. And you know, Kenny had predicted that he would, Coach Palestrini predicted he would go to state this year. So it looks like he's on his way, the first stepping stone right now. There he goes to the cradle move. He's got him in the cradle. Got 2 points, I think, on a near fall. The referee holding until he makes sure he's completely out of the first hold that he tried to score with.
Hasn't lost in league yet this year, and two-time defending league champion. He's our only two-time defending league champion in tonight's contest. In fact, there are only 4 returning league champs in the whole league.
Yeah, he's...
A lot of seniors won and graduated last year.
Yeah, a lot of them did. That was the thing with the Scotts Valley program is, you know, they had a number of wrestlers last year. This year their numbers are way down. And it's just hard to try and figure out why that happens. But Joseph Hermada is coached by Freddie Cortez and Helen Rossiter, team mom who's been with the program at Scotts Valley for a long time. He is 10-4 on the season. But Aguirre is riding him really tough.
And again, Jeremiah, SLV, cream of the crop in this league. He's again in the red and black, but two-time league champion, going for 3 in a row here, a senior. Hamana, only a sophomore, but in the finals of the league.
Aguirre is also interested in the future of marrying his high school sweetheart, which that's pretty good. He's got Hamana in trouble right now. He flipped him over. He's working on the near fall here, trying to put that half, that tight half. He gets that in there. We could see a fall here, Rusty. Well, he's got him now. He's got him in trouble. Officials calling, counting for the near fall. Remember, if he holds it for 5 seconds, it's a three-pointer. Less than that, 2 seconds or more, it's a two-pointer. There's your fall.
So Jeremiah, league champion for the third year in a row.
That's pretty impressive.
San Lorenzo Valley Cougar. Congratulations to the senior, undefeated in the regular season, and now the league champ here tonight, undefeated all day long.
Yeah, Aguirre now, he'll be one of the top seeds in the Central Coast section. When we, our league, we get two qualifiers out of this tournament, usually our first and second. But if the second and third place wrestlers have not met each other throughout the tournament, we wrestle for what's called a true second. And those true second matches, if they happen, will happen tomorrow at Harbor High School at 10 a.m.
Now we've got another star of the league in Raul Ortiz from Scotts Valley High School. And he's going against Evan Carrillo from Aptos.
Yeah, this looks like it could be a pretty good match here. Oh, a nice single. He's got him up in the air for the takedown. Ortiz has got a...
Ortiz has the gold on his singlet from Scotts Valley.
Ortiz is coached by Freddie Cortez and Ken Kennegaard. Ken, assistant coach, has been ill most recently, and he is not here this evening. Our prayers are with Ken. There, he's got him in the near fall now. Ortiz holding there for a near fall.
And Ortiz, another defending league champion. Winner last year, the SCCAL title. Raul Ortiz, ranked 7th in CCS.
Evan Carrillo from Aptos is 15-15 on the season. He was a former SCCAL league champ 2 years ago. And he was 5th at the Dusk and Dawn tournament. I don't know if he had some injuries or what, but I do remember him from a couple years ago.
So a great bout at 126 pounds, two league champions going at it for the title of 2017.
Ortiz is really working that tight waist, trying to trap the near arm, working for the near fall. And he's got him now, he's got him in trouble now with it. Scored a 2-point near fall in that particular move. So he is leading the match now. Looks like 5-0. Sorry we don't have the scoreboard within our view.
Yeah, it's a little tough to see at this angle. I think 6-0 on points. Carrillo beat Jack Greathouse in the semifinal Harbor wrestler in a close one. But Ortiz, the favorite, the one to beat, the senior.
You notice Ortiz has that brace on his shoulder, too, on his right shoulder. So he's wrestling at a little bit of a disadvantage tonight. There he goes in an inside ride for the tilt, armbar tilt.
Nearing the end of the first period. Well, that looks tough.
He's got Carrillo in trouble now. Oh, at the buzzer. Three-point near fall. So it looks like our score is 9-0.
9-0, Raul Ortiz with the lead over Carrillo. This 9-0, it looks a lot closer, and they've really been going at it.
Now, you see what happened there is it was Ortiz's choice. He chose to defer, and that gives the choice to Carrillo. Carrillo took standing wrestling in the second period. Now when the third period comes around, Ortiz will have his choice. Oh, nice double leg. Nice double leg, toes were in. You notice that at that point, if the toes of the wrestler executing the move are inbound, it becomes the points are scored. Oh, I guess they did not call it. Oh, there's Ortiz with a two-point takedown.
So Carrillo, a tall mountain to climb at this point.
Yeah, Freddy Cortez is asking about the last takedown just before this one that was not called. He had his toes in. It should have been a two-point takedown. Remember last year, Rusty, Scotts Valley, we had the mat lamp up above us, and boy, it was exciting. I thought we were at the WWF tournament, you know. I was waiting for Brock Lesnar to walk out any minute, you know.
Yeah, adds to the drama. I remember the old gym at Watsonville High School had great drama and the lighting. It's just one spotlight on the mat and center stage and everything else in the inky darkness.
Yeah. Yeah, the old Watsonville gym is still there, but they have that new facility. It's absolutely beautiful down there. Ortiz take a shot at the single leg, working the upper body with inside trip. Oh! 2-point takedown for Carrillo.
His first points of the match.
Yeah. Oh, nice rollout. Nice rollout there by Ortiz. That was,
the crowd
was almost out of there.
Evan Carrillo finally making a charge here. Now down 9-2 in points, second period. Carrillo again in the Aptos blue. A little tough to tell, but
yeah,
Scotts Valley has the gold on the legs.
This match is real good. There's Ortiz with a reversal, and Carrillo's got himself in real trouble, crawling on his elbows. He's being scored upon while he does that, while he's on his elbows. Ortiz will come up with another near fall here. There he goes, he tried to take him again with that cheap tilt. Uh-oh. Nice move, nice change up on that move by Ortiz.
Evan Carrillo from Aptos, a junior, so won league as a freshman. So he's still got a nice future. He's a good wrestler. He's up against one of the elite of the league in Ortiz.
And Raul Ortiz was first at the Jim Root Classic, sixth at the California Coast Classic, and he wants to thank his SECL wrestling community, and right back at you, Raul, that's a great thing. Evan Carrillo is a fighter here. This guy scores 13-2 in favor of Ortiz. Ortiz does a nice job of that, getting that foot across there and tripping Carrillo down.
So unless we have a pin here by Carrillo. Looks like Ortiz on his way to CCS, currently ranked 8th. And sure he,
ooh. Nice double leg takedown. That was a beauty. That was a, that's the one you like to teach the kids, and they do it.
We're in the third period. Cannot see the clock, so I can't tell you how many seconds are left, but we're nearing the end. 15-2. Ortiz with the lead on Carrillo.
Ortiz has a guillotine. Has a guillotine on him.
That's the Aptos contingent that's so loud here in the SoCal gym. We've got a lot of wrestlers and a lot of fans.
Yeah, that he got a tech fall on that. He's winning by more than 15 points, which is called a tech fall. Very, very skilled match, I thought. Raul Ortiz did a great job, and Carrillo was a great competitor to hang in there like he did. That was a really exciting match.
That really was. Well fought, as should be. Here we are in the finals. But next year, as a senior, Carrillo could go after league title number 2.
Ortiz
to deal with, that's for sure.
Yeah. Get back to the team scores here real quick. You know, Aptos was undefeated in the league this year. They were 6-0. And tonight, the scoring after the semifinal matches, Aptos is 174 points. Santa Cruz, 102 points. That is really moving up for Santa Cruz. SLV, 88. Harbor, 71. Scotts Valley, 60. Soquel, 49. And St. Francis, our new baby, 28 points. So I give them credit for scoring so well there as a first-year team. Here we go.
132, it's Brendan Fitzgerald against Ryan Braga. Braga out of Aptos, Fitzgerald, San Lorenzo Valley High School. 132 pounds, a freshman and sophomore. A lot of youth for a pretty good weight. Strong weight, 132.
Yeah, we have Ryan Braga from Aptos. He's coached by Rudy Guzman, Jacob Rodriguez, and guess who? Reggie Roberts. 15-12 on the season. 5th at Marin Catholic Tournament, 6th at Los Gatos Frost Off Tournament.
Brendan Fitzgerald out of SLV High School, 5-1 record in league, but he went up against Raul Ortiz, and that was his only loss. Ortiz jumped a weight, and so otherwise, in his weight class, he'd be sitting undefeated, and undefeated so far today to reach the final.
Yeah, Fitzgerald has a good record of 19-8. You know, that's nothing to shake your head at. You know, that's a pretty good number of matches.
And only a freshman. Again, Fitzgerald from SLV in the red and black. Braga and Aptos. Pretty much a solid black. Braga's the sophomore. Good wrestlers for being so young.
Yeah, he is very good. Nice single leg. Very, very nice single leg. For a two-point takedown. Converted that over from a single into a double. Took him right down. That's just the way you're supposed to do it.
Other two semifinalists in this weight class, Blaise Parrish and Kevin Chavez, also freshmen. But it's Fitzgerald and Braga in the final. Waning seconds of the first period.
Nice control there by Fitzgerald. Did a real nice job there controlling from the top position.
So Fitzgerald up 2-0 on points after the first period, first of 3.
Looks very well skilled for a freshman, I'll tell you that. Nice single leg shot there by Brega, but Fitzgerald was right there to block him off. And Brega tried to get a signal, tried to work on that leg, but Fitzgerald's not letting him get in there. Brega had the nickname of Baby Lou. He's nicknamed after his idol from the Nose TV show, Hulk, Lou Ferrigno.
Lou.
Still 2-0. Fitzgerald with the narrow lead from SLV.
Got a great double leg position, but they went out of bounds on that one. Fitzgerald is very impressive for a ninth grader, I'll tell you.
And again, only the one loss in league, and that was to the senior, the league champ, Raul Ortiz. And it was close. It was 7-5 when he went against Ortiz, and only a freshman. Brega, just a sophomore, so they're going to be duking it out for a long time, those two.
Yeah, they'll get to know each other real well. Fitzgerald has a great thing he wants to do also is make it to the state tournament. So that's a pretty big order for a freshman. But that's where it starts. You got to have those dreams, you know.
It's one thing to be a freshman at 108 and 115, but this is a tough weight, 132, yeah. 134.
That's where everybody is, you know.
The end of the second period, so 2 minutes left, and still 2-0 with Brendan Fitzgerald and slim lead over Brega. Brega hyping himself up. Here we go, the third and final period, 2 minutes.
Yeah, Fitzgerald chose to wrestle up on his feet, so that's where he's a nice double. Beautiful double leg takedown. That's textbook right there. That was very, very nice. Almost turned it into near fall points, but not quite. This kid's gonna be a real comer, I'll tell you.
So 4-0 on points, Fitzgerald with the lead. Third period, about halfway through the third.
Fitzgerald in control here all the way. Got that near side arm trap. Keep it broken down off of his base.
The two powers of the league, Aptos and SLV, as far as team wrestling is concerned. And they're showing it right here individually as well.
Brega tried to go into a switch, and Fitzgerald kept the arm bar on him. Oh, he's got it. It looked like he was going to take Brega over there at that point in time, but he can't. Now, you got to be careful of the arm. You can't have the arm up beyond a 45-degree angle, or they'll stop it usually as a potentially dangerous hold.
Gerald riding out the clock, and there's not much left. He's up 4-0.
Brega scores a one-point escape.
Less than 10 seconds. And that's it. So you have a freshman winning the league championship at 132, Brendan Fitzgerald, with a hard-fought victory over Ryan Brega. Another good one.
Yeah, the last two matches have been very, very good. Very, very well-skilled wrestlers.
Now we move on to 140 pounds. We've got Christian Olsen of Aptos High School, a senior, and Justin Parker out of St. Francis. That's Olsen who's out there now. The two have met before. Well, they met twice, Olsen and Parker, and they're 1-1, so this is the rubber match of the year.
Yeah, this would be a good one. Glad to see that St. Francis has a wrestler in the finals. First year program. Coach Guerrero is doing a great job there.
Justin Parker in the St. Francis purple. And coached by Nick Guerrero, who's just been so impressed with the strides that Parker has made this year.
Yeah, him and Brian Johnson, his assistant coach, they've done a great job there at St. Francis for a first-year program. I hope they just keep getting better and start getting a few more kids. You know, they only have 120 boys in the school. But he thinks he might have, oh, nice move. Olsen went to go around, oh. Parker's got him in a headlock now. He's got that headlock tight. He's got a score here. He's got a takedown. He's got a three-point near fall. He needs to tighten that thing up, and it'll be all over.
Which would be a huge upset. Olsen, the senior, undefeated. Yeah. Well, the one loss in league to this very Justin Parker. Olsen fighting for his life.
Yeah, he's got him tight. He's got to sit through with that and lift the head. He's doing the right thing on the move, but he's going to lose it. A five-point move, takedown and three-point near fall. That was very good for Justin Parker, I'll tell you. Justin Parker's 14-9 on the season, and he ranked third in the section. And Christian Olsen from Aptos is 20-11, seventh at the Jim Root, and sixth at the El Camino tournament. And he plans to walk across country in golden slippers after graduating from high school.
That I'd like to see.
Yeah.
Well, that's the end of the first period. How about that? Justin Parker, the sophomore, giving Olsen all he could handle. Up, I think the score 5-0 here as we begin the second period with the sophomore in the lead. So I see Nick Guerrero, the coach at St. Francis, I see why he was so impressed with his man Parker and just coming out first year wrestling and the strides that he did and turned himself into a real wrestler.
You got Parker's on top trying to turn Olsen. He's got the leg in on him. He's got his hips too high though. He could be in trouble. Could be in trouble here. If Olsen works his arm through, he's gonna be in trouble. There he goes.
Aptos fans getting loud, and so down by points, but Christian Olsen comes back and gets the pin. For the Aptos victory, Christian Olsen, the senior. Wow, what a match.
Well, I tell you, it's all about balance. He let himself get off balance there. Olsen was able to pull him right under with that headlock and put him away. So one good headlock deserves another, I guess. But that was some match, some turnabout.
Boy, Parker up on points. Great job by the sophomore, Justin Parker of St. Francis, who will become the first wrestler in the history of St. Francis to go to CCS.
Yeah.
Christian Olsen, the champ at 140 with that pin. Congratulations to him. Now we move on to 145. It's Mace Anderson of Harbor High School against Patrick Peoples of Aptos.
Oh. Mace Anderson, people took a shot there, and Mace Anderson just whipped him over on the side for a two-point takedown. Mace Anderson is one of our outstanding wrestlers. He's got a nice single leg here, right there, and he's trying to trip him down. There he goes. Nice trip.
That's Mace with the yellow.
And somebody's got blood on him.
So Mace from Harbor has the yellow headgear. And Mace, one of the only four returning league champions. So he's defending his title. Won last year.
Yeah, Mace Anderson is coached by Greg Lopez and Steve Bautista and Elroy Ruiz. He was second at the Weber Lawson tournament, fifth at the Coach Classic, and eighth at the CIT. And his record is 26-12, and he's ranked number five in CCS. So Mace Anderson is a very, from what I've seen, he's a very skilled technical wrestler. He just needs a little more strength, I think, and from watching what he's doing. Because you look at him, you look how tall he is, he's got the leverage. He just needs a little more strength. That's my estimation of him. But he's a kid who loves to learn. He loves wrestling, and he wants to go on, I think, and wrestle beyond the high school level. Very, very good student. Very high grade point average, and outstanding athlete. Patrick Peoples is coached by Rudy Guzman. Pete Mestis and Reggie Roberts, 14-4, third at the Marin Catholic, fifth at the El Camino, and he wanted to win the national look-alike winner of the Alfred E. Newman contest, which would be a heck of an honor.
Yeah, I'll say. All right, back to live action, still in the first period.
Mace Anderson cut Anderson loose so he could score. Comes right back in. You'll see he's very aggressive on his feet. Nice single leg trip. Now he's gonna let him go again. So he's gonna put on a takedown clinic for us. Nice shot by Peoples. Got his hips in the wrong position. Was not able to hold Anderson off. Anderson scored another 2 points.
Anderson up 8-4 on points.
Yeah, he's in a high crotch position now, but it also, oh, that was a beautiful move. You don't see a lot of high school kids that can do that. A lift like that, a body lift, that take you right to your back. Now he's gonna cut him loose. He's gonna score some more points here.
Mace Anderson up 13-4 on points. Just the first period, though, over Peoples. Peoples a junior, Anderson a senior, and trying to become a two-time league champ.
Yeah, he just goes for that high crotch and turns it into like a fireman's carry. Comes up on top for the two-point takedown. You know, looks like he is going to ride him out to the end of the first period.
The other two semifinalists.
There he's taking him again for.
And the clock runs out.
He just scored another 2 point near fall.
Semifinalists in this weight class that lost to both Mace and Patrick, Liam Parrish and Ruby Sartain Miller. Reaching the semifinals at 145. So here we go on to the second period.
There's Anderson again with that. Double leg change a single leg takedown to a double. Rolls up on the body, takes that far shoulder, trying to turn Peoples over. We might see a Tech Vol in this particular match.
Anderson up 19-5 right now. Early in the second period.
His optional start. Yeah, he took him right off his feet into a near fall. Very nice head move. Yeah.
So So there you have, with the pin, Mace Anderson defeating Patrick Peoples to become the league champion for the second year in a row. Mace Anderson from Harbor High School. How about that? Stays undefeated in league.
Well, I'm going to see him in the newspaper here someday as a champion. If he keeps improving the way he does, he's got a good chance to go on and really become a fine wrestler.
He's ranked fourth in CCS, so he could go out there and he has a shot at the title on to state. We'll see. So congratulations to Mace. We move on to 152 pounds. Rene Aguilera and Damon Regains. Regains out of Aptos, Aguilera from Santa Cruz High, the familiar red and cardinal and white.
Looks like a couple of real scrappers here. Aguilera is coached by Emilio Aragano, Cody Kiff, and Justin Bowers. Damon Raggins is coached by Pete Mestis, Ramon Zacharias, and Reggie Roberts. They're mixing it up real good here on their feet, Rusty. They're getting after it pretty good. We're at about the halfway point in the matches tonight. We've had some really good ones. Give you a little more information about these two guys that are up here battling right now. Damon Regains is just through a nice headlock.
Regains from Aptos has the draw right now and off the mat. So Regains,
I think he scored. Did he get a 2-point takedown, 2-point near fall?
What it is, so 2-0.
No, just the takedown, I guess.
Aguilera from Santa Cruz, a junior. Regains, a senior.
Oh, he's got him in a tough ride now.
Regains beat Hunter Blinkenberg in the semifinals. Another St. Francis wrestler who did very well. Again, the first year of the St. Francis program. And St. Francis coach Nick Guerrero is going to give Blinkenberg the wrestler award. He's just making it up this year because he's the perfect wrestler.
Oh, yeah. Nice takedown by Rene Aguilera. He just kind of whipped Regains over. He kind of shot it, was a little bit off balance. Came right up on top for the 2-point takedown.
Devin Gunderson, the other semifinalist in this weight class.
Yeah.
Two to three, close bout. End of the first period. So a nice little comeback there by Aguilera.
Yeah, real nice comeback.
He was down 2-0, now finds himself up 3-2, start of the second period. Here we go.
They go up on their feet now. Second period. They're really bad. Oh, nice throw. That didn't work out for him, and he lost a good try there. That was a nice try by Damon. He just couldn't quite get Aguilera over.
Aguilera now up 5-2. Again, Aguilera in the red and white, Santa Cruz.
He's running that cross face hard, probably looking for that cross face cradle. Trying to run that arm, pull it back in for an arm bar. Reagan's favorite quote is, "Don't look back, you aren't going that way." Well, oh, there he goes.
Nice spin.
Turned Aguilera over, and Aguilera reversed it on him.
Well, off the mat, another point there for
Aguilera.
And Regains got a point too. Aguilera's up 7-3. Second period.
Hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on.
Tough match.
Nice throw. Really, really nice throw by Damon Reagan. That was really nice. He took him down for two. Got to watch his bounce and his three-point near fall.
It's tied up, seven apiece.
He reversed it. Oh, he took him over.
Final seconds of the second period. They're even it. Roxley Aguilera goes up 9-7. End of the second period. Yeah. Oh, man, that's a good one.
Yeah, this is a good one. They reversed that lead several times.
Even at 7-7 a moment ago, Renee Aguilera now up by two, 9-7.
Aguilera takes bottom third period.
Start of the third. Regains out of Aptos. In the dark, singlet. Here we go, third and final.
Score 10-7.
10-7 Aguilera.
Okay. Yeah, this is a good battle. Aguilera working that front head and arm. Comes all the way around to get his head out of there, get two more points. He's up 12-7 now.
We know Regains can push points on the board. See if he can do it here.
Yeah.
Finds him down by five, third period.
Raggins is pretty wise on that. He lets Aguilera start to take him over, it looks like, and he's getting real dangerous because he almost reverses every time.
Aguilera up 12-7. About halfway through the third and final period.
Raggins tried to work his set out, but Aguilera's doing a great job of following him. That's one move, you just keep doing it and doing it and doing it until it doesn't work anymore, and then you go to something else. Oh, he's got the half in there deep. Oh, he's got him now in trouble. Got that half,
Regains fighting underneath.
Watch your balance. Aguilera had him there, and Regains came right out of it. He goes back over again. Geez, what a match, I'll tell you.
Aguilera putting the points on the board. He's up 15-7 now, yeah. Final seconds of the match.
And that's it.
Renee Aguilera of Santa Cruz High School, your league champ at 152 pounds. What a battle, hard fought, Damon Regains. That was a good one. Regains took the early lead, and Aguilera stormed back and won the title. Wow. That's been a lot of good matches and going a good long three periods. I mean,
yeah.
Most of everything. You know, we're getting some, getting our money's worth tonight.
Yeah.
None of those first period pins.
Yeah, here we have the first and second place teams and the team score battling each other right here. Marcos Reyes from Aptos against Jesse Jesse Berry from SLV. Nice double leg shot there.
Both these wrestlers highly ranked in CCS. Berry is seventh in the section. It's a lot of schools. And Marcos Reyes of Aptos is ranked 13th in CCS.
Yeah. Got him in that, looks like he's got him in that front head and arm. He's trying to spin here, block the elbow and spin in behind for a 2-point takedown. But Barry's a little too smart for that.
When these two teams met during the regular season, Aptos and San Lorenzo Valley, very close. Aptos came away with the win, but partly because SLV had to forfeit two weight classes, and Aptos got those points automatically. Short of that, the other six bouts, they were sick. They were They were six and six.
Barry came up with that cradle, almost had to complete it, lost it. Ended up just scoring a two-point takedown. So Barry's coached by Ken Palestrini and Todd Kraft, 16 and 6 on the season. Half Moon Bay consolation champion. Apple Cider third and Overveld tournament fourth. And his personal goal, he's got two of the greatest one, is to win a beauty pageant and also to wrestle a bear. So he's got his work cut out for him later in life.
I'm not so sure about some of these goals they've been writing down.
He's riding on tough on top to that, trying to work for the tilt. Trying to control that near side arm for an arm bar if he can.
Barry, a junior out of SLV. Ray is only a sophomore. Big kid for a sophomore, wrestling at 160 pounds. So yeah, again, when the two SLV and Aptos trying to make the point that they had 12 matches and each team won six of them.
Yeah.
And then SLV had to forfeit the other two.
Yeah, these two
Aptos
guys.
Aptos wins the team regular season match.
Yeah, Marcus Reyes was from Aptos, was 22-6. First at the Harbor Frost-Off, fifth at Marin Catholic, third at the El Camino tournament. And he wants to be an all-state running back in football. Well, that Aptos program is pretty powerful. Randy Blankenship's got him going over there, and he's just liable to do that. Tried to get a headlock on that time, Marcus Reyes did, but he could not keep a hold of Barry like he should have and ended up losing 2 points on the maneuver.
So Barry up 4-0 in the second period.
He's looking like he's turned. He's got about a half. Oh, and there's a fall.
Jesse Barry of San Lorenzo Valley High School, the champ at 160 pounds. With the second period fall over Marcus Reyes, only a sophomore. Reyes, you'll be seeing him next year, of course, as well as Barry. And sure they'll both fare well at section.
Yeah, they're both two good looking wrestlers, I'll tell you.
Interesting how Aptos and SLV during the regular season, the two best teams, but yet today it's Santa Cruz who's got in there in second place for the team title. And here we go at 170 pounds. It's Keegan Dutton Jones of Aptos against Donovan O'Brien of Santa Cruz.
Nice head pull down and takedown there by Dutton Jones. Riding on top, he's looking for that cheap tilt. Got the vine in there. He's gonna try and get him up off his shoulders and control that near side arm. What he's looking for.
Dutton Jones, the Aptos junior, ranked ninth in the section.
Has an impressive record of 23-7, and was third at Marin Catholic, third at El Camino, fourth at Jijin Roop and fourth at Overfelt. So, he's still got some room to grow, that's for sure.
Both these wrestlers are juniors.
Donovan O'Brien was third at the novice tournament. So I don't think they've been to a lot of the bigger tournaments like some of the other teams have. And down the road, that could hurt you, but when you're building a program like Mr. Coach Aragon is over there, you don't want to take those kids into tough competition too early and get them discouraged.
Two nothing lead by Dutton Jones.
Yeah, he's got a tough ride. He's working, trying to work that arm bar. If he can turn the head under, he's got O'Brien in trouble now.
O'Brien fighting to get out of the pin. Still a lot of time here in the first period. Looks like he might work his way out of there.
Yeah, it looks like going back to base. Yeah, good fight. Oh, he's got the deep half. Now he's got him.
So Keegan Dutton Jones with the first period pin over Donovan O'Brien, the two juniors at 170, and your champ right there, Keegan Dutton Jones of Aptos High School. Well, ranked ninth in the section. See, he can go out there and certainly make a mark next weekend.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Ethan Spence is another wrestler at 170 here today, the semifinalist. And now we move to 182. They just keep getting bigger and bigger. It's Chris Abanez and Armando Membrino. Abanez from Aptos High School, Membrino from Harbor. Membrino with the yellow headgear. And only a freshman, Membrino, at 182 pounds. Abanez, a senior, so freshman versus senior. Abanez hasn't lost in league this year. He's the favorite coming in, again from Aptos. No points on the board, just the start, first period.
Oh, that was a nice shot. Abanez, nice takedown on that. He just reached in and grabbed a hold of Membrino's legs and took him over. He's working the half. He's got that thing tight. Got that thing real tight. He's working him over. Doesn't quite have a near fall yet. He's working hard at it. You need to reverse that into a half. Got the head now. Now he needs to power him over. He's starting to get his near fall points. There, he got him to rock over. If he could get him to rock over.
Going for another first period fall. We could have two in a row here.
Yeah.
Banya's up 2-0. He's got.
Need to tighten that up.
Well, Membrino might be saved by the bell here.
Yeah, the knockout will not happen. Oh!
So with
that had to be right
to go in the first period, he gets the pin.
That had to be right at the buzzer.
Chris Abanez of Aptos High School. So Aptos on a roll. They're racking up the points now as the team. The senior wins the title at 182 pounds. So SLV, Santa Cruz, and Aptos close during the regular season, but now Aptos seems to be maybe pulling away. And we move on to 195 pounds. It's Adam Vega of Aptos High School. He's there in the center of the mat right now, and he's going up against Danny Cruz of Harbor, both outstanding wrestlers. Ranked both of them in the top 15 in CCS. Here we go at 195 pounds. It's Cruz with the yellow headgear. Vega of Aptos, the senior. Cruz, the sophomore.
Danny Cruz, coached by Steve Bautista and Greg Lopez at Harbor. His record is 19-11. He's ranked 15th. CCS, and he was 8th at the Coach Classic, which is, you know, a very, very tough tournament. Adam Vega is coached by Pete Mestis, John Velez, and Reggie Roberts. He's 18-7, ninth ranked. He was 2nd at the Marin Catholic. Almost. Real close takedown there by Cruz. You look at the body style difference on these two guys. You have the tall guy and you have the short guy. So leverage becomes a factor here. It can become. So you usually have to overcome a lot of strength. Nice shot there by Cruz, but he just couldn't hold it. Lost 2 points here. Adam Vega from Aptos would like to go into Marine Corps, what he's done with school, and serve our country, which is a very, very nice gesture on his part.
Indeed, boy, wrestling practice would certainly beef you up for being a Marine in boot camp. That wrestling practice, no picnic, is it? Talking to an Olympian and Pat Lovell, 1964 Olympics. You've had a lot of blood, sweat, and tears probably all over wrestling mats across the world.
Vega got off a little balance there. It looked like Cruz was going to put him on his back, but he wasn't able to get him over, and Vega ended up back on top again.
Surprising, Cruz, only a sophomore. A big kid, the Harbor High School wrestler. Parked underneath here as we get set to go. Second period. It's only 2-0. And Vega with the edge.
Yeah. Vega has to be a little bit careful on his balance. He wants to, you don't want to get up too high on a short guy who could roll. Put that roll move on you, you could be in trouble.
Only 2 matches left after this one. The heavyweight, Tom Deck.
There was a nice move by Cruz. Again, Adam Vega just lost a little bit of his balance and just couldn't quite get in the right position.
So Cruz, the sophomore, ties up the senior Vega. It's 2-2 here in the second period.
Yeah, there he goes. They're going to reverse positions here again, I think. Yep. Vega coming up on top for 2-point reversal.
So Vega up 4-2. Other 2 wrestlers, semifinalists at this weight, Cody Bryan and Nick Scott. But it's Vega and Cruz made their way to the final and duking it out right here.
Yeah, Vega's trying to work that arm bar. If he get underneath that shoulder, he'd be able to turn him, but can't quite get the position.
Vega currently ranked 9th in the section, where Cruz 15th. So he's got a future. Boy, that Cruz, only a sophomore. And
Vega's just kind of rhymed him out now. Cruz is trying to get the stand up, but he can't quite do it. Potentially dangerous hold there. The referee was right on top of it to make sure the wrestler was not injured. Stopped it before it could happen. Very nice job.
Vega trying to get another win for the Aptos Mariners. Their SLV has a number of wins here individually, so the team title could be closer, and we haven't got a good update in a while.
Yeah.
But it'll be SLV and Aptos right to the bitter end.
Yeah, they're right down the wire. There we go. There's Vega getting up off balance again. Cruz is going to get out of there. I think he got his 1 point escape, did he? Or...
See, I can't see the scoreboard right now. Yep, looks out. Well, I can't tell. I can tell you we're about to start the third period.
Yeah.
2 minutes to go. That's 4-2. Vega with the lead.
Same thing, you know. Cruz started a roll under to roll, and he got put himself right in a bad position and went right to his back, which allowed Vega to reverse him, you know. You got to be careful of that. There you go, Vega working for the tilt. Working for the near fall. There he goes, he's got the near fall. Got the arm bar on him.
Vega hasn't lost in the SCCAL this year.
Got him in trouble now.
And he gets the pin. Adam Vega, your Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League champion, with the third period pin over Danny Cruz. Impressive performance, reaching the finals, the sophomore Cruz. And Vega, there's your champion and your future Marine, going into the Marines right after graduation. How about that? Adam Vega, your champion at 195 pounds and another win for Aptos. So I think Aptos and SLV each have right around four or five individual wins. They're going for the team title as well. And now we move on to 220 pounds. It's Caleb Martin of Aptos, the senior, going against Carlos Mercado, a sophomore out of SoCal High School.
This is our first shot of a SoCal guy. You know, they've been here, like we talked about earlier, they got the guys in the big weight. And that was a nice lateral drop there by Mercado. Did a real nice job on that. Real nice job on the lateral drop. Scored his 2 point takedown and Caleb Martin is a senior, coached by Pete Mestis, John Velez, and Reggie Roberts. 16-6, 13th ranked at CCS, 5th at the El Camino, 5th at Dawn to Dusk, and he's riding tough.
Mercado, only a sophomore. He's a sophomore on top, he's got the blue singlet.
He's coached by Shane Torres. Shane's young coach here at at SoCal High School, who's keeping the program going here, and we hope to see better things from SoCal in the future. Mercado's all over him here. He's a very good rider here. He's following Martin very well. He is 14-7, and he's ranked 17th. Oh, he took pressure.
So the sophomore's got the bead on Caleb Martin. Martin might be able to escape. Wow, there's an upset. Carlos Mercado from SoCal High School hands Caleb Martin of Aptos his first loss of the year in Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League action. So, again, only a sophomore from SoCal. Carlos Mercado, there he is. Congratulations at 220 pounds.
Well, they don't have the quantity at SoCal, but they have the quality. And in that young man, that was a nice job.
Soquel's got some weight in this next one as well. Well, Dave Gabriel, he lost in the semifinal. Then you had Ty Cunningham also in the semis. But now, as we go to the heavyweights, it's Adrian Luna of Santa Cruz High School just stepping out into the mat against Matty Maestas of Aptos. It's our final match of the night. Maestas is a senior, Luna, Santa Cruz, a junior. Here we go.
Matthew Maestas in the blue uniform, and Lima in the red uniform from Santa Cruz. Lima, current record is 2-1, and he wants to play football and work out in the weight room, which is very doable. Matthew Maestas, coached by John Velez and Pete Maestas, his dad, and Reggie Roberts is 14-11, sixth at the Jim Root, fourth at the Dawn to Dusk, seventh at the Weber Lawson, and he wants to put a gym together for puppies, which is a very, very nice gesture.
Looks a lot like your style of wrestling, the Greco-Roman.
Yeah, yeah. The two big boys battling out.
First period, no points on the board yet. The heavyweight division, yeah. 286.
Stalling call on Red, trying to throw that headlock. Mestis is trying to get the body lift on him. Lima keeps backing up. He's going to get called for stalling. A lot of hands to the face here. I don't know if the referee is going to let him continue to do that, but they're battling each other. Trying to work inside. Work inside the upper body, trying to get something set up.
Last seconds of the first period. It is a Greco-Roman wrestling match, isn't it?
Yeah, this is a Greco-Roman match. I remember that style.
Yeah. All right, so 0-0, start of the second period. We only have 4 minutes of wrestling left tonight, Pat Lovell.
That's right. They're going to battle it out here, both up on their feet. Doesn't look like they want to get down underneath one another. Going to work that upper body. Got to be careful here not to back up. You know, the referee will... is looking for somebody to call here for stalling, I think. There's no action whatsoever, no attempts whatsoever. There's 1 point stalling call against, goes against Lima. Lima was called for stalling the second time. Maestas gets 1 point for that. Sorry. Adrian Luna, I'm sorry. Looked like I had Lima down there, but Luna.
Cheering on Luna from Santa Cruz. Down 1-0.
The fans are going wild in this one.
Santa Cruz and Aptos, both.
Two big guys. Oh, he's got him in the bear hug now. You could just throw him. Watch out what happens here.
And off the mat. Oh. So just 1 point scored so far. Maestas with the lead, 1-0, midway through the second period.
I think the last time they wrestled that Luna upset Maestas, beat him, and that was a real turnabout, you know. Yeah, they're still battling. Somebody will have to take a shot here pretty soon we're going to have all stalling calls.
End of the second period, so 2 minutes left. Yeah, it's like you haven't had a knee hit the mat yet in this bout. Here we go. The last 2 minutes of the night. Who will take the heavyweight title?
He's going to have to hold him down here. I don't know if he's going to be able to do it. He's going to have to hold him down. It doesn't look like Luna's got those baby legs. He's got some thighs on him, boy. He's going to fire out of there. Here he goes. He's up. Oh, there goes Mestis. He's got him on his back. He could have a fall here, Rusty.
Much to the delight of the huge Aptos crowd, it's Matty Mestis with the win for Aptos High School. With the pin in the second period, make it the third period. Listen to those Aptos fans.
That was a great show by the two big guys. Finally, Mestis had the internal fortitude to take that guy and lift him up and put him over. That was a really nice move on his part.
And your 14th champion of the night. It all started when Chris Markey at 106 pounds from San Lorenzo Valley won the title. And then Gabby Sandoval, the league champ at 113 pounds, her second title in as many years. Jeremiah Aguirre won at 120 pounds from San Lorenzo Valley High School. It was Raul Ortiz of Scotts Valley High School with the technical fall on points who won the title at 126 pounds. And Raul is the winner of the Ed Farrell Most Inspirational Award for 2017. Brendan Fitzgerald won the title at 132 pounds from San Lorenzo Valley High School, and he's only a freshman. Christian Olson won at 140, came from behind for that win. Mace Anderson, the star out of Harbor High School, won at 147. The champion at 152, Renee Aguilera from Santa Cruz High School, is Jesse Berry, the Cougar of SLV at 160. The champ at 170, Keegan Dutton Jones of Aptos, and he started quite a run for Aptos. Chris Abanez won at 182 for the Mariners, and Adam Vega at 195. And then it was the SoCal Knight, the one winner for SoCal tonight, Carlos Mercado at 220.
When you're the host school, you got to get some gold.
Yep.
You got to get some gold.
And Matty Mestis won that bout we just saw, the heavyweight. They've got listed at 286 from Aptos High School. And that might have sealed the Aptos Mariner team title. Hard to know exactly.
The kids did a great job tonight. All the matches, some were overmatched, but all in all, it was a great night for SCCAO wrestling. And we want to wish the best to all these young lads going on to CCS. And look forward to see them in the future,
Yep, 14 new champions, so and a lot of youth. So some, of course, some seniors, some, we even have a freshman champion.
Yeah, that's pretty unusual, to have a freshman as a champion.
Well, Pat, it's been a pleasure. I've done a number of these league championships with you over the last 20, 30 years. They're always fun, and it's always fun to listen to your expertise, your play-by-play.
Yeah, it's been a long haul, Rusty. I enjoy working with you and with the community TV people. It's been absolutely super.
I should thank the community television of Santa Cruz County, the crew here. We've got Victor Herman, who was our director, and our two cameramen were Lynn Dutton and Scott Gray. Brought you the match tonight. We hope you enjoy the broadcast. It'll re-air several times. The ice packs and the bloody noses, and it's a tough night.
It's all part of the game, That's where they learn to be a man in this sport. That's the reason why.
That's for sure. All right. Well, for Pat Lovell and the Community Television, the Santa Cruz County crew, I'm Rusty Reed saying so long. A very special thanks to SoCal High School for putting this on. And, of course, Aptos High School, Reggie Roberts, who helped with a lot of the notes and helped put on a great show.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
All right, gang. So, for Pat Lovell, I'm Rusty Reed saying so long from the 2017 Santa Cruz Coast Athletic League Wrestling Championships. No, that's so weird.